Hello student, namaskar. Now let's move towards another new concept, that is a uniform and non-uniform linear motion. To understand this concept, here the one example is given. Amar, Akbar and Anthony, these are three friends, are traveling in a different car with different velocities. The distance covered by them during the different time of intervals are given in following. In the first year, the time interval is given. They start for traveling at 5 o'clock, and then we measure the distance traveled by both Amar, Akbar, Anthony after the half hours. In first half hours, let's see first example, motion of Amar. In first half hours, that from 5 to 5:30, means in first 30 minutes, Amar travel 20 kilometer distance. In second 30 minutes, again it travel 20 kilometers. In third, means from 6 to 6:30, third 30 minutes, it travels again 20 kilometer. In every 30 minutes, Amar travel a same distance, that is a 20 kilometers. Now see, in about Akbar, a distance travel by Akbar. In first 30 minutes, Akbar travel 18 kilometers. In second 30 minutes, it travel again 18 kilometers. But in third 30 minutes, third half hours, he travel only 6 kilometer distance. Again, the fourth 30 minutes, he travel 28 kilometers. Then, in fifth half hour, he travel 20 kilometer, from 70 kilometer to 95 kilometer. And last half hours, he travels 25 kilometers. Means every half hour, means every 30 minutes, same time of intervals, Akbar travel different distance. Now let's see Anthony's motion. Here Anthony travel in first half hours, Anthony travel 14 kilometers. Again second half hours, he travel again 14 kilometers. Means 14 to 28 means 14 kilometers. In third 30 minutes, again it travel 14 kilometers, same distance. Means here Anthony also travel same distance in same time of intervals. And therefore, in these three example, Amar and Anthony both have uniform linear motion, because they travel a same distance in same time of interval. But Akbar travel different distance in same time of intervals, and therefore motion of Akbar is called non-uniform linear motion. Now see non-uniform speed. If an object covers unequal distance in equal time of intervals, it is said to be moving with non-uniform speed. Akbar speed is a non-uniform speed, but Amar and Anthony's vehicle speed is a uniform speed. The motion of the vehicles being drive through the heavy traffic, during the heavy traffic, is a non-uniform speed. Now let's see what is acceleration. For that, here we are going to perform one simple activity. Take 1 meter long plastic tube and cut it lengthwise into two parts. Take one part or one of the channel shaped part, place one of its end on the ground here and another end at some height from the ground as shown in figure. Take one small ball and release it from the upper end, from this end, and observe the velocity of that ball. At this point, the speed of ball or velocity of ball is a minimum. At here, it is maximum. Again, at the end of this channel, the velocity is become zero. Means the velocity of this ball get changed continuously, means that ball possess acceleration. When velocity of object is changed, then that motion of that object is called accelerated motion. You must have all play on the slide in the park. You know that while sliding down, the velocity is less at top, it is increased as the middle and again become zero towards the end. Means your velocity along that slide is get changed. The rate of change of velocity is called as acceleration, and therefore formula of acceleration is equal to change in velocity upon time. Change in velocity means what? Final velocity minus initial velocity. Final velocity minus initial velocity is called change in velocity. If the initial velocity of object is u and the final velocity of object after time t is a v, then acceleration a is calculated by this formula: final velocity minus initial velocity upon time, and therefore a is equal to v minus u upon t. It is a formula for acceleration. Now acceleration, there are three type of acceleration. When the velocity of object is increased, then that object possess positive acceleration. When velocity of an object is increased, the acceleration get present in that object, or acceleration in that object is called positive acceleration. If the velocity of an object is decreased with the time, then that object possess negative acceleration. The negative acceleration is also known as a declaration. It is called negative acceleration. Its direction is opposite to the direction of the velocity. Means direction of acceleration is totally opposite to direction of velocity. The third type of acceleration is a zero acceleration. When object, the velocity of object does not change with time, it's remain constant, then it has zero acceleration. Suppose motor car is moving with uniform motion, means velocity change, there is no change in velocity, then that object possesses zero acceleration. The object in a rest position also have zero acceleration because there is no change in velocity. Thus it is these are the three types of acceleration: positive acceleration, negative acceleration and zero acceleration. The unit of acceleration is SI unit, MKS unit is meter per second square, and CGS unit of acceleration is centimeter per second square. विद्यार्थी मित्रो, आजच्या व्हिडिओमध्ये आपण इथेच थांबूया आणि या झालेल्या टॉपिकवर मी तुम्हाला एक ॲक्टिव्हिटी शीट पाठवणार आहे. या व्हिडिओचं पुन्हा पुन्हा अवलोकन करा, पुन्हा पुन्हा हा व्हिडिओ पहा आणि ती ॲक्टिव्हिटी सोडवा, वहीत सोडवून ठेवा. शाळा सुरू झाल्यानंतर आपण ती चेक करू. आणखीन इतर विज्ञानविषयक व्हिडिओ पाहण्यासाठी माझा यूट्यूब चॅनल सबस्क्राईब करा आणि त्यातले व्हिडिओ लाईक करा, शेअर करा इतरांना. वेगवेगळे व्हिडिओज सायन्सच्या संबंधित मी त्या यूट्यूब चॅनलवर अपलोड केलेले आहेत. जर तुम्ही चॅनल सबस्क्राईब केलात तर नवीन नवीन व्हिडिओ निश्चित तुम्हाला पाहायला मिळतील, त्याचं नोटिफिकेशन तुम्हाला मिळेल आणि सहज ते व्हिडिओ तुम्हाला पाहता येतील. धन्यवाद विद्यार्थी मित्रांनो.